Hello to all my dear students. I welcome you again to the online video class of computers. I'm Meenakshi Kothiyal, your computer teacher. Children, I just hope that you all are fit, fine and healthy at your home. And keep on studying. Okay, children? Now, today we'll be going to continue with our previous chapter, that is chapter number 3, Advanced Features of Word Processor. Children, in our previous module, we have studied about the word processors means what is a word processor, what is the purpose of it. Okay, we have covered the introduction part in our previous video. Also, we have studied about the tools in which MS Word is divided. Okay, MS Word is categorized into three categories. We have already studied about the formatting tools in which we have studied about Format Painter, how to use a Format Painter. Okay, next we have I've told you that how to give a shadow effect to any shape or to any word art text. I've already shown you in my previous video. Those who have not viewed it, they can watch my previous video to learn how to do these changes in your document. Okay, children. Next, I've told you what is superscript and what is subscript. How you can apply these superscript and subscript in a document. That I've already told you. Now, today we'll be continuing with page number 44. And our next topic is editing tools. Formatting tools we have done in our previous video. And in this video, I'll be going to tell you about the editing tools. Okay, children? So, for this, we have to do the practical first. I'll be telling you how you can use the editing tools. Okay, children? So, let's have a look. So, now, children, in this video, I'm going to tell you how to add header and footer in your document. Okay, children? For this, you have to open your page number 44 of your book. Okay, now children, we have already studied about the formatting tools. Now in this video, we are going to study about the editing tools in which we'll study about the header and footer and how to add the header and footer in your document. Okay, so children, what is header? Header is a text or graphic that we add at the top of the page and it will get displayed on all the pages automatically. Okay, now one of the easiest method to enter the header in your document is see children, here you can see a blank space is there. Okay, so what you have to do, you just have to simply double click on it. See, here header appears. Okay, now here the cursor is blinking. Now you can type any heading. Okay, now suppose if I want to type ICSE Understanding Computer Studies. Okay, now come out of the top of the page and click, double click anywhere. Okay, see, a header appears on the top of the page. Now what is the use of it? When you will come down to the next page, okay, see, this is page number 1. Now when you will come to page number 2, when you scroll down, you will see that a header, see, this is page number 2, you will see that a header is automatically appearing on the on the top of the page. Now you can simply add it. See, I have not given any space between the ICSE and Understanding, so you can edit it also. If you want to edit it, you have to double click on it and then edit from here also. And if you want to come out of the header part, then you have to click anywhere on the double click anywhere on the document. Okay, so see, this is the use of a header. If we have typed any header once on any document, it will get displayed automatically on all the documents. Okay, children. So now here I have come to page number 1. See, so this is the header. Okay, now this is the easiest way. And if you want to apply the next way, like as it is given in your book, that to add header in a document, you have to perform these steps. Now what are they? First, open the document. See, the document is open, and if you want to insert header or footer, what you have to do, you have to simply click on insert tab. Okay, from here also we can do that. Okay, insert tab, then third step is click header. See, this is the header and footer group, this.
This is the header and footer group. Okay, now click on header. See, I've clicked on the header group. Now it displays the built-in options. These are the built-in options, means these are the styles in which you want to format your header. Okay, now click an appropriate built-in style from this drop-down box. Okay, now see, if I select this banded portion, then the header will appear like this, and you can add it here also. Just click on it and type your heading. Okay. So this is also another method to add the header. See, now if you will come to the next page, that is page number 2, see, the header is appearing here also. See, this is the header. Okay, children, so this is why we use header and footer in our. So now, children, let us understand how to insert the footer in our document. What you have to do, you have to scroll down the page and come at the bottom of the page. See, this is the bottom of the page. Now what you have to do, the simplest method is that just double click at the bottom. See, footer. Okay, this area is the footer area. Now whatever you can type, suppose I want to type PTO. Okay, I'll just shift it towards the extreme right side. Okay, see, I have typed the footer over here. Now you can see that this footer will automatically get appeared on the next page also. See, this is the page number 2. Here you can see, this is the page number 2. The footer is already appeared on it. So the number of pages we have typed, the footer or header will appear on those number of pages. Okay, children, now you all must have understood how to insert the header and footer in your document. Okay, children. So now, children, our next topic is inserting columns. Okay, now I'll show you how to insert columns in your document. Now, children, you must have seen that in a newspaper, in a magazine, the things are not written in a proper way, means they are divided into some columns. Okay, they are not written in only one page. Okay, they are divided into columns. So let us see how to do this. Okay, now what we have to do for this, we have to follow these steps. First, we have to select the text. Okay, now select the whole text. Okay, see, now selected the whole text. Now what is the second step? Click page layout here, layout option, page layout. Okay, now in this you have to click on, see, this is the page setup group. This is the page setup group. In this you have to click on columns. Now, children, by default our document is divided into one column. Okay, only one column we have by default. Now if I want to divide it into two columns, I can select it from here. See, now I have divided the columns into two. See, the document is divided into two columns. Okay, now whatever you will type, it will get displayed in two columns. So this is how you can insert the columns in your document. Okay. Now, if you do not want any columns in your document, so what you have to do, you have to click on, again on the column and click on 1. See, no column is appeared on the screen. Okay, children. Now, come to page number 49. Our next topic is working with tabs. Children, in your keyboard, a key is present named tab key. Okay. Now, what is the use of that key? Tab key is used to give more spaces at a single time. Means it will give you a space, a gap of 0.5 inch at a time. Okay. Now, there is a difference between a tab key and a spacebar key. Okay. When I press the spacebar key, see, like this. Okay. Now, if I press the spacebar key, it will give you the space like this. only single gap. Okay, it will take time. But if I click on the tab key, look at the cursor, it will go, it will increase the gap size. Okay, now children, see, let me show you how to use the tab key. Suppose I have typed the name, okay, I want to give space. If I'm using spacebar key, it will give you space like this. Okay, I have to press the key many times. Okay, now if I use it with tab key, I have typed this. Now if I press the tab key, the cursor will give me the space, more space at a time. See, so I do not need to press the backspace key again and again so many times. So for this purpose, if you want to give a long gap at a single time, you have to use tab key. Okay, see, a tab key, if I'm pressing a spacebar key, see, it is giving a single space. But if I press tab key, see how far it is going. Okay, so for this purpose, we use tab key. Okay, children. So now, children, our next topic is indent text and margin. Okay, now what is indent? Indent means to set a line or a paragraph of a document. Okay, now see, children. For this, we have to, if we want to apply an indent on our document, we have to click on layout option. Okay, the first step is to select the paragraph. See here, I have selected this paragraph. Okay, now step number two is click page layout. Here, layout option, we have clicked it on. Now under indent, where this is the indent option. Okay, now if I click on the left indent, means if I click on the up arrow, see, this is the up arrow, left indent, up arrow, what it will do, see the changes at the down, see, it will move your paragraph towards the right. Okay, now if I decrease its indent, if I decrease the left indent, it will bring the document towards the left margin. Okay, children. So this is how you can indent the spacing of your of the starting of your paragraph. Okay, so this is how you can change the, if you increase, it will move towards the right side. Okay, far from the left margin. If you decrease the left indent, it will bring the paragraph towards the left margin. Okay, the same way you can apply this for right indent also. Okay, if I increase it, see the changes, and if I decrease it, see here, the indent has become till this line. Okay, now by default, the system sets the left and right indents to 0. Okay, so these are the indents. Okay, now next is margin. Now children, as you can see that this is the margin, this much margin is left, means till here we cannot write any word, till this margin we cannot type any word. Okay, here also, till this margin we cannot type any word. So if you want to set margin on your document, what you have to do, again on layout option or layout tab, we see that at the extreme left side, margin option is there, margins. You can adjust the margins according to your choice. What you have to do, you have to click on the margin option. If you want to select the normal, it is, see, the it will give you the normal space. This is the default space, normal margins are there. Okay, as you can, as you have seen the margins in your notebook, from where you have, you start the writing, from where you start writing down, same way the margins are also provided to you in the document also. Okay, if you want to again set the margins like narrow, see, the narrow margins are there. Okay, again, if you want to make it wide, see the margins. See, from here, if you will start typing, the text will get start typing from here. Hello, everyone. See, the text is started typing from here. It will not get started typing here because the margins we have selected is wide. Okay, if I select it in narrow, see, it will get start typing from here. Okay, children, so this is how you can select the margins. Okay, you can select the margins normal. By default, the system is selected to the normal margin. Okay, children? Now, what is page orientation? Page orientation means the direction of the page. Okay? See, this is the portrait way. This is the portrait direction. And this is the landscape direction. If we print out something like in this manner, then it is portrait. But if we printed some matter in this way, then it is landscape. Okay? Let me show you how you can change the direction of your document into portrait and landscape. Okay. Now, children, by default, the direction of a document is portrait. Okay. So, now if you want to change the page orientation, you have to follow these steps. Now, according to your book, what is the first step? It is written, select the document or page or paragraph whose orientation you want to change. See, suppose this document, document's orientation I want to change. Now what is the next step? We have to click on page layout tab. See, this is the layout tab. It is already clicked. Okay. Now what you have to do? Select the type of orientation, that is portrait of. See, this is the orientation. See this. Okay. What you have to do? You have to click on this orientation part. Now, see, by default, our document is in portrait. Okay. Now if I click on landscape, see, the width is increased. The width of the page is increased. Okay. And the height is decreased. See. Okay, children. So, this is how you can do change the orientation of a document. What you have to do? You have to click on orientation option. Now, it is a landscape. So, I will select portrait. Okay. So, this is how we can change the orientation of the page as per our need. Okay, children?
So now, children, I just hope that you all have understood the topic very well. Okay, you all must have know how to use MS Word. Okay, children? So watch the video very carefully, and if you are having any computer at your home, you can also try it at your home. Okay, do the practicals of yourself. I've told you how to do them. Okay, now you can also try it at your home. I'm not taking your much time, I'm taking your leave. I'll be going to meet you in my next video. Till then, complete your work, send me your assignment as soon as possible. Okay, and note down the correct answers. Okay, children? So, till then, stay safe and stay home.